Welcome everyone. We are discussing about this and morphology of the flowering plants, in which we are discussing about flower. We have already discussed about the first three floral parts, that is calyx, corolla, which are the non-essential or accessory organs of the plant, and we have even discussed this antherium, which is one of the essential or one of the reproductive organs present in the plant, that is the male reproductive organ. Antherium is the male reproductive organ. So it is comprised of stamens. Antherium comprises of stamens. Each stamen will be having two parts. One is tube-like structure, which is called as filament, and on that tube-like structure, a head-like structure is present, that is called as anther. Okay, and anther is bilobed. Two lobes are present in anther, and inside those lobes, sac-like structures are present, which produces pollen grains. Inside those sac-like structures, pollen grains are produced. Now we'll move on to the last floral part, that is gynoecium. The last floral part, that is gynoecium. This gynoecium is the female reproductive part. Gynoecium is the female reproductive part. Okay, so each gynoecium is comprised of pistil or carpel. It is made up of pistil or carpel. Pistil and carpel are one and the same. So gynoecium is comprised of pistil, or we can even say gynoecium is comprised of carpel. Both of them are different words, but they are the same. So each pistil or each carpel consists of three different parts. Like antherium, we have seen stamen. Antherium is comprised of stamen. So each stamen consists of two parts, anther and filament. So in this also, in gynoecium also, that is each pistil consists of three parts. Each pistil consists of three parts. This is the structure of pistil or carpel. This is the structure of pistil or carpel. So it is also called as gynoecium. Gynoecium consists of pistil or carpel. So each gynoecium, that is, there can be only one pistil or one carpel, or there can be more than one pistil or one carpel. If we find only one pistil, then that condition is called as monocarpellary. Monocarpellary, that is only one carpel. If gynoecium consists of only one structure like this, one carpel, then that is called as monocarpellary. That condition is called as monocarpellary. If it has more, that is two carpels. If it has two carpels, this is one carpel. If it is like this, if it has only another carpel, then that condition is called as bicarpellary. Mono is one. One carpel, monocarpellary. Bi means two. Bi means two. So two carpels means the condition is called as bicarpellary. Okay, that gynoecium is bicarpellary. And if it is three carpels are there, tricarpellary. It depends on the number of carpels present in the flower. Okay, so gynoecium, it is the female reproductive part. It consists of one or more carpels. If it is one carpel, monocarpellary. If it is two carpel, more carpels means if it is two, bicarpellary. Three, tricarpellary. So if it is many carpels, then it is called as multicarpellary. Multicarpellary. Three carpels or more than two carpels, we can even say multicarpellary. But if it is given three carpels are there, tricarpellary. Okay, four carpels, tetracarpellary. But instead of mentioning three and four, if that is more than two, we can even say multicarpellary. You can say multi-carpellary. So it might be, it will be having one carpel or more than one carpel. So here it consists of each carpel or each pistil consists of three parts. Each carpel or each pistil consists of three parts. This, the swollen at the base of the thalamus, a swollen like enlarged basal part. Enlarged means that is large, swollen part. Okay, swollen part at the base of this pistil. So it is from here to here. So this is the base. This basal part is enlarged. Okay, this enlarged basal part is called as ovary. The swollen or enlarged part at the base of the pistil, then this part is called as ovary. And on this enlarged, that is enlarged part, here we have elongated tube-like structure. On this enlarged part, we have this tube-like structure. This tube-like structure is called as style. This tube-like structure is called as style. And at the tip of the style, there is a receptacle. There is some organ, so that is flat head-like structure will be present. This is called as stigma. It is called as stigma. So each carpel or each pistil consists of three different parts. Okay. So first is the up top part. This is the receptacle. It receives, this is the part which receives pollen grains. It is the tip of the style. At the tip of this, this is the style. At the tip, at the top position of the style, we have a receptacle, receptive surface. This is called as stigma. What it receives? We said it is a receptive surface. It receives something. The stigma, it receives something. What does it receives? It receives pollen grains. It receives pollen grains. Okay, so it receives pollen grains. This is the stigma, which is at the tip of the style. This is the connection between stigma and ovary. Style is a connection. This is the middle part, which is the style. It is a connection between the stigma and the ovary. The style is connecting ovary with the, that is ovary and stigma. Okay, so this is the middle piece. So receptive part, it receives pollen grains. Okay, it receives pollen grains. Then tube-like structure is there, which is called as style, and the basal enlarged part, which is called as the ovary. So each pistil or each carpel consists of three different parts: stigma, style, and ovary. And stigma, at the tip of the style, we find this enlarged basal part is ovary. Elongated tube-like structure is style, and the tip of the style, a receptacle surface, is a receptive surface is present, that is called as stigma. So each carpel or each pistil has three parts. First is ovary, second is style, and the third is stigma. Now inside this ovary, ovules are present. Inside the ovary, ovules are present. This is the ovary, na? Inside this ovary, ovules are present. Ovules are present inside the structure. Like the structure will be there, ovules will be present inside the structure. Inside the ovary, ovules will be present. These ovules are attached to this ovary through a cushion-like structure. This is the ovule. Inside this ovary, ovule will be present. Ovules can be one or it can be many. Inside single ovary, we find one ovule, or we can find one ovule or more than one ovule. Inside each ovary, we find ovules. It can be one ovule. In single ovary, one ovule can be present, and in single ovary, many ovules can be present. Okay, inside the ovary, ovule will be present. okay, inside each ovary one ovule can be present, or it can, each ovary can have more than one ovule, and those ovules will be attached to this ovary through a cushion like structure. This structure is called as placenta. They are attached, the ovules, this is the ovule and this is the ovary. This ovule is attached to this ovary through a cushion like structure. This cushion like structure is called as placenta. A flattened cushion like structure is there, which is called as placenta. With the help of this placenta, ovules are attached to ovary. Ovules are attached to ovary. Now, if it is one carpel, I already said you monocarpellary, two carpels, bicarpellary, many carpels are multicarpellary. Okay, if three carpels are present in N, if all the carpels are free, if three carpels are present and if all the carpels are free, for example like this. So this is one carpel, this is another carpel, okay, this is another carpel. If all of them are free on the thalamus, if all of them are free, then not attached to each other, then that condition is called as apocarpus. Apocarpus means free carpels. That is free carpels. They are not fused. The apocarpus, this type, if we have this type, na, then it is called as, this condition is called as apocarpus. Means the carpels will not be fused together. They are free. Each carpel is free, not attached to one another. So such condition is called as apocarpus. Such condition is called as apocarpus. And if all the carpels are fused, for example like this, this is one, this is another, this is another, and all the ovaries are fused. If all the ovaries are free, they are not attached, then this condition is called as apocarpus. That is, ovary is not fused. But here, these, all these three, the ovaries of all the carpels are fused together, making only, appearing like only one ovary. Okay, so this condition is called as syncarpus, that is fused ovary. Ovary, free ovary. Ovary will be free, not fused with each other. Here, ovary is fused. All the three ovaries, if it is having three carpels, all the three ovaries are fused together. Such condition is called as syncarpus. Such condition is called as syncarpus. If the ovaries are free, if there are more than one carpel, and if the ovary are free, not attached, not fused with each other, then that condition is called as apocarpus, which we see in lotus and rose. This condition which we see in lotus and rose, whereas syncarpus, that is all the ovaries will be fused. If more than one carpel is present, the ovaries of the carpel will be fused. Then that condition is called as syncarpus. And this condition which we see in mustard and tomato. Like many are there example which we see, that is common examples are mustard and tomato. Now coming to this one, another important topic in this gynecium, that is the placentation. Placentation is nothing but arrangement of ovules within ovary. Arrangement of ovules within ovary is called as placentation. What is placentation? It is related with the word placenta. I already said you, placenta is nothing but a cushion like structure which is joining the ovule with the ovary. It is joining the ovule with the ovary. Okay, so on this placenta how the ovules are arranged inside the ovary. Okay, ovules, where the ovules are present? They are ovules are present inside the ovary, but they are attached to this ovary with the help of the placenta. Placenta is the connection, is the tissue which is connecting the ovule with the ovary. Placenta is a cushion-like structure which is helping in the attachment of ovule to the ovary. Okay, so how placenta is present, where placenta is present, and how the ovules are attached to the placenta. So that arrangement of ovules on placenta inside the ovary, arrangement of ovules in the ovary is called as placentations. Arrangement of ovules within a ovary is called as placentation. Okay, this is also important in very short questions also, for short question also. Okay, only what is placentation? It will be for very short questions. And what are the different types of placentation? What is placentation and what are the different types of placentation? It is a 4-mark question. So what is placentation? Arrangement of ovules within a ovary is called as placentation. Okay, so these arrangements will be of different types. Ovules are attached within a ovary in different types. So we have that arrangement is called as placentation, and we have this placentation is of different types. The placentation is of different types. The first type of placentation is marginal placentation. Then we have axile placentation. Then we have parietal placentation. Then we have free central placentation. And we have basal placentation. So how ovules are arranged inside the ovary? So according to that arrangement, we have different types of placentation. Okay, first we will move on to marginal placentation. Marginal, the word itself is saying, it is at the margins. That is, ovules are attached to the margins of the ovary. Ovules are attached to the margins of the ovary. Okay, we have seen this P. Mater. So inside this, the P is nothing but one ovary which we see. This is one ovary. So in this is the open one. So if it is, it will be closed now. The piece will be closed. So this closed P is one ovary. It is one ovary. Okay. So on this, this is the dorsal, this is the ventral side. This is the ventral side of ovary. This is the ventral side of the ovary. On the ventral side, a ridge is present. On the ventral side of the ovary, a ridge, dandy, a ridge-like structure will be present. On the ventral side of the ovary, a ridge-like structure will be present. Okay, so we will tear it off. To open it, we'll tear it off. So that is nothing but the ridge. On the ridge, we have placenta. That is, on the ridge of this ovary, the ovules are attached. That is, matar, andar jo matar ke dane hai, those are nothing but ovules. Those are nothing but the seeds. This ovules will change into seed and ovary will change into a fruit. I said you, this is the ovary, and inside the ovary, ovules will be present. So after reproduction, when the ovary, that is after reproduction, na, this ovary, this will fall off. The stigma and style will fall off, and this ovary will change to fruit. This ovary will change to fruit, and this ovules will change to seeds. Okay, after fertilization, after all the reproduction has taken place, fertilization is over, the ovary will change into fruit, and the seed, ovule will change into seeds. Okay, ovule will change into seeds. So here, these are the ovules which are nothing but now changed into seeds. So they are attached at the margins of the ovary. They are arranged in two rows. If you open it, at one side few will be attached and another side few will be attached. If I keep another, that is another pea, like this, if another pea na, so here at this one na, like this will be attached, like this, on this one, at the ventral side. So they are present in two rows. This is one row, okay, and this is another row. So they are present in two rows. The pea, that is the ovules, are present on the ventral suture. I'll remove this. They are present at the ventral suture, okay, a ventral ridge of the ovary, and these ovules are attached at the margins. They are present in two rows. So this type of attachment of ovules to the ovary, so this type of placentation is called as marginal placentation. It is called as marginal placentation, okay. So as the, it is, that is example of it is pea plant. We see this type of placentation in pea. If the seeds, if the ovules are attached to the axis, ovules are attached to the axis, in this axis, in the center. So these are the ovules. These are the ovules. It is multilocular ovary. That is multilocular ovary. So many locules, division sept are there. So it is the seeds, if the seeds are arranged here, some soft cushion like structure will be present, and on this na, at this, in the middle, in the center, at the axis, the ovules will be attached. So if the placentation is like this, then this type of placentation is called as axile placentation. So this type you see in tomato. You open it like this horizontally, you cut the slice horizontally. In the center na, soft cushion like structure will be there, and on that cushion like structure the seeds will be attached. Those seeds are nothing but the ovules which has been turned into seeds. So they will be present at the center on the axis. So this type of placentation is called as axile placentation, which we see in tomato, lemon also. Many locules are there, okay. In lemon, many locules are there, and the seeds which, or the ovules, are attached at the central axis, okay. And the next type of placentation is parietal. That is, in this type, na, the ovules are arranged at the periphery of the ovary. Periphery means not, that is away from the center. This is the center and this is the periphery, away from the center, okay. So inner wall, we can even say inner wall. For example, this is the outer wall of the ovary and this is the inner wall of the ovary. Outer wall of the ovary, and this is, lemon is one ovary. So inside this, in the middle it is present, that is axile placentation. So in this na, in this, the, in parietal placentation, the ovules are attached at the periphery. Ovules are attached at the periphery. So in this na, a false septum will be seen. In this, a false septum will be seen. Actually, there is no division. There is no division. But what happens is, so it appears like there is a division. It appears like there is a division. Many chambers are there. For example, this, in this, there is no chamber. Only one chamber is there. No, only one, inside ovary, only one chamber is there. So in this ovary, many chambers, that is one chamber, two chamber, three chambers are there. Divisions are there inside it. Okay, but here, there are no divisions. But when we see it now, we find that there is a false septum. We find that there is a false division will be seen. Cucumber. In cucumber, there is no division, but it appears like it is, there is division is there, that is chambers, three different chambers is there, but it is only one chamber. It is only one chamber. It appears like there is division, there is a divide, there is a chamber, there is a wall, but it is not the wall. Okay, so here in parietal placentation, what you remember here in marginal is the ovules are attached at the margin. In axial means they are attached to the axis. Axis will be in the middle, center. They are attached to the axis. Parietal means periphery, far away from the axis. So it is attached to the inner wall. If we see, this is the outer wall of the ovary and this is the inner wall of the ovary. So ovules are attached to inner walls, we can say, or we can even say ovules are attached at the periphery of the ovary. So such placentation is called as parietal placentation, which we see example of this is mustard, archimone. These two are the common examples of parietal placentation. Then coming to it, here the next type of placentation is free central placentation. The next type of placentation is free central placentation. So in this, na, here septum is there, division is there. In the lemon, in that is Mozambi, lemon, that is orange, we see that is not orange. Here in lemon we see septum. Small, that is septums will be seen like this. But here there are no septums and the seeds are present in the middle. Here also seeds are present at the middle. Here also seeds are present at the middle. But here septums are there. Divisions are there. Within the ovary, divisions are there. Inside the ovary, many chambers are there. Here, inside this ovary, there are no chambers. The seeds are attached to the center itself, but there are no chambers. So that is why it is called as free central placentation. Free central placentation. No septa. Remember this. Inside this ovary, there is no septa, means there is no wall, there is no division, there is no chamber. Here, septa is there. This is one septa. Okay, this is another. This is one chamber. This is one chamber. This is another chamber. This is another chamber. Okay. But here, there are no divisions, no septa, no chambers, and the ovules are attached to the center. Okay, here also center, here also center, but here in this axial placentations we have septum, divisions are there, many chambers are there inside the ovary, here no chambers. So this we see in Dianthus and Primrose. These two are the common examples of free central placentation. And last one is the basal placentation. At the base of the ovary, for example, this is the ovary. At the base of the ovary, this one, at the base of the ovary, one ovule will be present. Only one ovule will be present. So this type of placentation is called as basal placentation. That is, at the base of the ovary, only one ovule will be present inside the ovary. Okay, so this type of placentation is called as basal placentation, which we see in sunflower, marigold. These are the two common examples for basal placentation. So here we have discussed everything, that is gynecium, which is the female reproductive organ. It consists of three parts: stigma, style and ovary. Inside this ovary, ovules will be present, and how the ovules are attached to the ovary. Okay, so that is called as, that arrangement is called as placentation. This placentation is of many types. Marginal placentation, ovules are attached to the margins, ventral sutures of the ventral, on the ventral suture a ridge is present. On the ridge, on the margin, the ovules are attached. In axial placentation, inside this ovary many chambers are there and the seeds are arranged at the center. In parietal, the seeds are arranged at the periphery of the ovary or inner wall of the ovary. And in free central placentation, the seeds are attached to the center itself, but there are no chambers. Okay, here inside this also there are no chambers, but there appears as false septum. It appears, but there is no chamber. Okay, and in this basal placentation, only one single ovule in a ovary, and that will be attached to the base of the ovary. So with this we have finished this, the fourth reproduct, that is fourth part of the flower, that is gynecium. Next, we'll start with inflorescence.